Welcome back to Broke-Ass EDC. Man, I got a little special here. I did a little swip swapping around because I saw one of these and it got my attention. Because you know I love a Chavez clip and I like the Dagger clip. So I like a clip with a little bit of personality. And man, did I find another one from Freak Show. I got my chance to join the family and picked up a demon from Mr. Mike Carell himself. This one already luckily had the carbon fiber inlay on it. Comes with the steel. Man, S35VN. This is a heavyweight steel line locker. And that's what drew me in, was that Celtic cross on the back. Something a little different, a little pop there. But then that's where I kind of dove into this thing and thinking, man, that's a little bit different. Because most folks go straight to the titanium. This thing is a heavy wanna be user. With that S35VN blade, razor sharp. I mean, it's ridiculous. Let's check her out here. Move everything up here. Get situated here. Got the little cards that come in with it. This thing's a damn newborn. It was born on 1/6 this year. You're lined up. And we're looking at little over 7, maybe 7.5 inches. I guess depending on where you want to start measuring the blade at. A little over 3.5 inch long. Like I said, I should have put it on a scale because I mean it's definitely a heavyweight. Thumb studs is how you plan on opening this bad boy, either with the reverse flick or the thumb deployment. And all of the lines in this knife hit exactly where you want to ergo-wise. You got the finger choil kind of built into the frame here. No jimping up top, a little bit of a thumb rest there at the back, but nice smooth surface to lay your thumb on to do some cutting. And I found these on the old Facebook. And there's the Freak Show family, and there is always some type of onlay that seems to come up from time to time, so that you could really manipulate and dress these out however you want. Multiple different finishes, and there's always something new coming out with the Freak Show family. It's definitely something I'll leave the links in the video, so you can go over and check Mike's stuff out. Seems like a pretty cool dude. Got to chat with him a little bit. Even said that he would come on Saturday night with us and talk about the demon and some other things he's got going on. I think this is a V1 right here. They held back on who is putting these together for him. But working with Misfit Machine and Tool on a V2, and it's going to be very interesting to see how that pops out. But definitely something different here with the steel. All kinds of the onlays that can be chose. And that crucifix on the back in that pocket clip. Billboarding. Simple. Elegant. Got the FS for the Freak Show. Everything else, it just lets the design speak for what it is. Hardware, you've got just what you need. Enough to hold on the clip. Nice clean looking pivot. It's not captured. I don't think it's free spinning. And looks like lefties are out of luck on this one. And it's definitely not a deep carry. You've got quite a bit of blade sticking out there and a generous lanyard hole if you want. I haven't put the steel back on it. I probably just leave the carbon fiber. I like the feel of it. It's got some nice traction in it. And I watched the old website because I plan on, hell, might want to see one of these other scales or hardware set come in to dress this thing up even more. But great action, drop shut, and the knife feels solid, like it's ready to do some cutting. Lockup is solid on it, nothing, no complaints there whatsoever. Good looking knife from old Mike Correll there in the Freak Show. Drop a comment. What do you think of the Freak Show design? Go over and take a look at some of the other stuff, man. There's some great patches and everything in that group. And, yeah. Like, subscribe. What else did I forget? Check out the Knifeaholic Saturday night. Yeah, I think that's it, folks. Y'all, stay sharp. Stay safe.